If you can go to page 6, you'll be seeing a range of CCTV components we're going to be working with today. Let's have a look at some of the CCTV components we'll be looking at. So we have the cameras. We'll be looking at DVRs. We'll be looking at MVRs. And we'll be looking at hybrid. Your hybrid DVRs. We'll also be looking at cables and connectors. For other cables and connectors, we're looking at various cables like coaxial cables, like your RG58, your RG59, balance, your RGC. We have power supply connectors, so we're going to have power supply connectors. I have a couple of them here, I'm just going to show you. So you just pass these around. These are balloons, one after the other. These are power supply connectors which we'll be using. This is a BNC connector. Just pass it around the class for them just to see. This is not the practical session. I just wanted to have an idea of these connectors for beginners. These are the units we're going to use to view our video footage. So we have, you can view it on a VGA monitor. We have a plasma screen, an LCD, your normal TV set, all these can be used to view footage of the your CCTV. Now I'm going to just flip through to one of the slides. I'm not happy with the DVR, and these are other versions of the DVR. The DVRs are used for analog cameras. The MVRs are used for digital cameras, otherwise known as the IP cameras. And the hybrids are used to process more than one type of video signals. They are used, they can handle analog cameras, they can handle digital cameras, they can handle HD cameras, high definition cameras. Now, we have three basic types of video signals. We have the analog signals, the analog video, which can be processed using the regular DVR. We have the digital video from your IP camera, which is your MVR for. We're going to be looking at the various parts of the DVR. Now, in front of you, I have a hard drive and a DVR on each and every one. So you're just going to share. So as we are, I'm going to use this to illustrate what I'm trying to show. So you can open up the DVR in front of you. So you have a DVR in front of you. Let's look at the various parts of the DVR. The first part you have is the video input, the video in from your camera. Now, the DVR is often defined by the number of video channels they can take. So let's say you go to a vendor and you want a DVR, the first thing is going to ask you is how many channels. So you have them come in different video channels. As you can see, the one on the screen is a four-channel DVR. And you have your video input, so that's where the cameras are going to be fed to the DVR. Can you identify the number of channels of the DVR in front of you, please? So how many channels do you have on
this show?
That's eight channels. That's four channels. Okay, that's eight channels, and that's four channels. All right. And you can identify the video input. So you can see the video input once the router B is so these are the 448 and out. Now the video inputs are labeled, so you have channel 1, channel 2, channel 3, and up the number of channels it can take. Now the next is, we have the video output. So we have the VGA video output, that's number 2. Now, when you are getting a DVR, it's always advisable to get a DVR that has multiple video outputs. For example, it's advisable to get a DVR that has a VGA video output, a BNC video output, as you can see here, and a HDMI video output. The reason is, you might have some clients that require you to terminate the video on HDMI, and you may not be able to do that if the DVR, well, you can do that using a converter, a VGA to HDMI converter, but sometimes they don't work. So it's advisable to have. Now, this is a PTZ camera. A standard camera is going to have a couple of cables coming out of it. Let's look at what we have. You have on your camera, so you have your lens, and sometimes you have a sensor. You have your LEDs, your infrared LEDs. So you're gonna have a video cable, a video input. You have power, and in case of in the case of a PTZ, you're going to have control. So now, on this PTZ camera, this is the video input. This is the power input. This is where the camera is powered, and this is the control. So this control input is terminated on the RS-485 connector. That's this point on your DVR. So that's where it's connected. Do you have any questions on the DVR? Any questions on DVRs? Now, your DVR does not come... Okay, somebody is trying to ask a question. Yeah?
It's possible for me to combine cameras, express video of camera and another brand of DVR together.
Yes, you can.
Like we're having Sony camera, using a DVR of the make of
Swan,
Iris.
Yes, you can do that. The full meaning of DVR is digital video recorder, sometimes referred to as PVRs. That's personal video. Sure, how this thing works now in the next phase of our practical session. Is there any more questions on DVRs before we move on to MVLs? All right, in the absence of any more questions, we'll take a short break and we'll start with MVLs.